Do you think we should be nation building, or do you think we should be focusing
on... I'm not a nation builder. We're after terrorists, period. And the thing that's different about Vietnam, and I grew up in the Vietnam era, is that Vietnam was a war that was unpopular. But those bastards didn't follow you home. These will. That's the difference. Don't want them in my neighborhood, so it's better to fight them there. But rules of engagement, when you sit there and you put handcuffs over our children fighting a war where they have to sit there and identify 5 times who somebody is as an enemy, is not exactly what Audie Murphy did in the Second World War. And he was our, you know, he is to me a poster child of the way we should fight wars, take no enemy, and win.
So waterboarding, and is that legitimate in some situations to use those kind of...
Well, I'm certainly not familiar with the Bush technique. I'm not even going to say the Bush technique. I would say that particular Bush administration. That's not my forte. I don't torture people. But on the other hand, I'll do anything necessary within means to try to get information from people. But I don't think torture is the right way. And I don't know, and I'm not an expert on waterboarding. I really don't know that much about it. I don't know what went on. I'm always... certainly in the fact that we have treaties and we have ways to fight wars. But I believe that wars should be fought to win. And if we're in Afghanistan, we should try to win. And certainly Iraq, we've obviously had some great success. So I think it's going in the right direction in Iraq.
How is it great success? They're not even able to elect a government, a formal government.
But you look at, we don't have, what is his name, Saddam Hussein anymore in the neighborhood. That's sort of a good thing. And weapons of mass destruction, whether they had them, whether they didn't, we see now that they probably didn't. Would they have them right now? Like, if I was a betting man, I'd say they probably wouldn't. So, you know, it's a lot, when you look at the scenario, is the world a better place without Saddam Hussein? I think there's no question it is. So there's some success there.